So this article is part of a growing evidence base on the efficacy of ultrasound biofeedback intervention. It's the idea that there are a lot of children who will respond well to your conventional forms of treatment, your auditory modeling, maybe some articulator placement cues, but there's always a subgroup of children who don't respond well to that conventional type of treatment. And for those children, we'd like to provide an enhanced sensory experience and see if they can use that information. So in biofeedback, we're giving a real-time display of some aspect of speech and seeing if the child can use that to produce a better version of their target sound. We know that the R sound is a challenging one to treat because it involves a complex tongue shape. Actually, most speech sounds are produced with just one major constriction or narrowing of the vocal tract, and the R sound actually involves two constrictions. There's an anterior constriction and there's a posterior pharyngeal constriction. So the retroflex and bunched in the title are two of the major categories of tongue shape that you'll see adults using to produce the English R sound. The retroflex tongue shape has the tongue tip pointed up and maybe curled back a little, and the bunched actually has the tongue tip down, but the tongue raised up in a bunched shape near the palate. One of the questions that we were looking at is, what do clinicians choose to target in intervention for R misarticulation? Do they encourage a retroflex tongue shape? Do they encourage a bunched tongue shape? And which one is going to be better? And in our study, we were showing children the shape of the tongue for R, and we had to make an explicit decision. If we're giving them a model, should it be a bunched R? Should it be a retroflex R? Should we let them see both of them and choose whichever one? And we actually, all of the clinicians who were treating as part of this study had a bunched R. And there's also some evidence that bunched R is more common than retroflex R. So we said, look, we're gonna try and use the bunched R as our default model. And we had four children try that, and they didn't respond particularly well to the ultrasound biofeedback treatment, which surprised us because we know that ultrasound biofeedback has proved efficacious in other studies. And one of the qualitative observations that we made during the course of this treatment was that one of our participants who wasn't responding well to the treatment stumbled upon a retroflex tongue shape. We had been cueing her to produce a bunched tongue shape, and then she accidentally slipped into a retroflex posture and it produced a really perceptually accurate R. And so we reinforced that. And then that made us say, well, maybe we can't fit all of these kids into a single tongue shape. Maybe we should be letting them explore which tongue shape is the right fit for their vocal tract to produce a perceptually accurate R. And so we recruited a second cohort of children and made a minimal modification in the study protocol where they were given some pictures, MRI images of adults' tongue shapes for R, and they were told, everyone's R is different. You have to find the R that's right for you. And they got to try out different retroflex, bunched, intermediate variants, and we found a really substantial difference in the response to treatment then, where it seemed that letting the child find the best fit for their vocal tract was more facilitative than cueing all children to imitate the same tongue shape. There's pretty good evidence out there now that if you use some sort of technology enhancement, if you use biofeedback to give the child an enhanced experience of speech, that can be helpful for some of these children who just don't seem to be responders to traditional forms of therapy. Most clinicians don't have access to these technologies. They don't have an ultrasound, an EPG. They don't have the specialized software that creates the visual representation of the acoustic signal. So I've been teaming up with an interdisciplinary group at New York University, including some engineers, some computer scientists, to develop an app, an iOS app that will provide visual biofeedback that will allow clinicians to implement this same acoustic biofeedback treatment that I've been researching in my lab. And the idea is that the app is going to be free. We're not selling it. We want to increase the impact of our research. We want to translate our research into practice, so we want to make sure that it's accessible. So the app is currently in development, and I'm going to need input from speech pathologists to know what will make it more user-friendly, what will make it useful for them. So I'm looking for speech pathologists to pilot the app in a school setting, a private clinic setting, and I'd really appreciate if anyone who has an interest in this would just follow the link to sign up, and then they'll receive mailings and further information about opportunities to get involved in this project. If we want our research to have an impact, then we have to get it into the hands of practitioners and make it easy, make it free, and make it make sense to someone who's actually doing the intervention.